will discuss now the laparoscopic tissue approximation techniques. And in that, I will discuss all the type of knots and the sutures, which is generally used in the laparoscopic surgery. Imagination is more important than knowledge. It was said by Albert Einstein. All the surgery, the 90% of the things what you do, it is according to your imagination, your common sense. Because the surgeons and the physician, both have their complete difference in the protocol. Physicians, generally, they have more theoretical knowledge and they work on their complete knowledge of the medicine. But in the surgery, you need to dream your surgery. Basically, it is a skill. And knowledge is less important than a skill. And a skill will be better if you can imagine better. Albert Einstein has said, imagination is more important than knowledge. Reason behind that, his all discoveries were like that. First he got the result, and then he tried to do the research that why, how to prove that result. Exactly same way, in the minimal access surgery, there were a lot of imagination of the different type of knots. And those knots were implemented. Initially, when it was started, then titanium clip was the only thing which was available to stop the bleeding. Titanium clip has the one good property that it is inert. It doesn't react with the human tissue. It is very soft and malleable. So this was a good idea to use it. But later it was found that clip is not very safe. If you are using clip, it should not hit any organ, otherwise that organ can be damaged. And you can lose the clip also inside. It should be perpendicular to the structure. And both the limb of the clip applicator must be visible while you are clipping. For that, you might have done the practice that you should turn the light cable in such a direction that you can see from behind the structure also, to visualize the tip of the clip. A good dumbbell formation should be there. After applying the clip, keep it pressed for 3 to 5 seconds. After applying, don't open it immediately. Keep it pressed for 3 to 5 seconds so that there will be the plastic deformation of the tissue. Plastic deformation means permanent deformation. And then you should open the clip applicator. After that, it won't be loose. And a good dumbbell should form. A good dumbbell formation means the clip is really occluding the structure. If the dumbbell is not there, that means it's not good. Next important thing is that the tip of the clip must project beyond the healthy margin. It should must project beyond. Because if it is not occupying anyhow, it's just occluding, then it will be a problem. When you are clipping it, at the time of cutting also, you should take care that the tip of the clip applicator, that this is the, or the scissors, must be under vision. Are clip completely safe? Initially, it was thought that the clip is not a good idea because it can create a lot of other complications. What is the most common is cystic duct clip stone, that is also known as cat eye stone. There are 360 cases of the cat eye stone already been reported up to 2002. That data. And the cat eye stone, why it develops? Because if the one of the limb of the cystic duct will clip will get internalized inside the cystic duct, then it will act as a nidus for the bile salt and bile pigment to keep on depositing there. And it can form a cat eye stone. Why the name cat eye stone is given? Because if you will take a cross section, you will see the pupil like a cat inside, and then it can create the problem. So the knotting is better. That is also in some of the book it is written, cat eye stone like cystic duct clip stone. Knotting is better. If you apply the knot, it should be used with the help of the knot pusher, and then you can tie the cystic duct pedicle and then you can take it out. Laparoscoping and suturing and knotting, generally we are reluctant. The surgeons, they don't want to practice it. Why? Because it is time taking, lack of confidence, interrupted practice, improper selection of knot type, improper technique of knotting, difficult hand-eye coordination, long cylindrical instrument, two-dimensional vision and poor ergonomics. These are the most common reasons generally we are reluctant to knotting. There are two types of knot. One is extracorporeal, another is intracorporeal. Extracorporeals most common are Rodder's knot, Milger's knot, Tayside knot and Tumble Square knot. And others are Western knot and Square knot, which you have already used. Now the intracorporeal, there is Surgeon's knot, Square knot, Tumble Square knot, Dundee Jamming knot and Aberdeen termination. These all are intracorporeal. So both the type of knots are available. Suture material for a small tubular structure like a small appendix or cystic duct, or sometime you can use the dry chromic catgut. Although chromic catgut is no more available in the European country, but in India still it is used sometime. If you are using chromic catgut, it should must be dry. If you get wet, then you cannot slip it. The outer surface will be peeled off and your knot may break. So don't allow it to keep it over the tissue for a long time. Just after putting the endo loop inside, tie it immediately. Another is that for intracorporeal continuous or interrupted suture, Vigil is the best. And white Vigil is even more better. Reason behind that, if it is bloody filled, the violet color Vigil will not look very clear. But if you use white one, it reflects the light and the vision is more clear. Gore-Tex is also used for intracorporeal suturing. Silk also can be used for intracorporeal suturing. Main behind the intracorporeal suture material should not have memory. It should be easily manageable, like silk, like Vigil. The structure which has a memory is not good for the intracorporeal suturing. Like the catgut is not good, the proline is not good, the PDS is not good, nylon is not good, because it has a lot of memory and it is slippery. So slippery structure, if you will tie the one wind and you will apply the first knot, if you are going for second, first will be loose. For extracorporeal material, same way, the slippery materials are better and the braided material are not good. For extracorporeal knot, silk is not good. Vigil is also not very good. PDS is the best. Why? Because it is monofilament and it slips nicely. You won't have problem of slippage. Silk will always break. Vigil, it can be used. PDS is better than Vigil. For a structure where you need the permanent repair, like hernia, like fundoplication, like rectopexy, in those situations, polyester, that is Dacron, should be used. Dacron is a polyester and that can be used as a suture material. There are three stages of knotting. First is configuration, that is tying. Second is shaping, that is drawing. And third is securing, that is snugging or locking. So configuration, shaping and securing, that is tying, drawing and snugging. All the three steps should be correct. If the configuration is not good, like for the Rodder's knot, it should be 1-2-1. And if you are doing 1-2-2, then that means it is not good. Configuration should be correct. Second is shape. Shape of the knot should be always better, always good. Shape means from outside itself, when you are about to push it, if it doesn't look good, if it is not extracted properly, if it is elongated, if it is overridden with the one over another, then you should stop it at that time only. Tie it again. That is shaping of the knot. Another is securing, that is locking. When you went there, and if you see there is no good dumbbell formation, you have any doubt that it is somewhere it is trapped, then it is not good. You should tie another. And remember that knot is either exactly right or hopelessly wrong. It is never nearly right. If it is wrong, then cut it and tie another. Never take a chance over the knot. First knot we will discuss here, the Rotter's knot. These all knots were basically developed by the mountaineers, shipmen and weavers. Weavers who is weaving the cloths. Mountaineers using to climb over the mountain. Mountaineers, they use extracorporeal knot, isn't it? They make the winds, throw it over the heel, pull it and they climb. The weavers, they use intracorporeal suturing. And ship person also, they use extracorporeal knots. The first extracorporeal knot was used in the tribal time. Ancient human, they have used knot, first extracorporeal knot, to trap the animal in the evolution of the human, to trap the animal. And later, they start using the same extracorporeal knot to hang their enemy. After putting in the neck, they were hanging it. But we have started this extracorporeal very nicely to hang the specimen, to tie the specimen. Extracorporeal knot is seldom used by the general surgeons in open surgery. It is rarely used. But in laparoscopic surgery, this is one of the very important skills every laparoscopic surgeon should learn. Whenever you are in trouble, either in gynae or general surgery, your friend is extracorporeal knot, because it can exert a lot of tension there, and all the shape, configuration and locking should be nicely understood, and keep on practice this. Now there are two lengths of the extracorporeal knot available. You should use 90 cm or minimum 75 cm. 75 cm can be used for the free structure. Free structure is like appendix, like some of the fimbrial end of the tube, like some ovarian cyst or ovary. That is free structure. And for continuous structure, you can use 90 cm minimum. If it is 1.5 meter, then it is even better, that you can apply multiple knots. Now, how to tie Rotter's knot? You will see here that the suture should be held in your hand in such a way that short limb will be left side and long limb will be right side, and then cross the hand. And the cross the hand in such a way that short is now over the long one. And then take your index finger and thumb to pinch it here. This way you will pinch it. And then always follow the principle of coming from below up. So this is the first wind. This is the first wind taken. And then you can take the... This is first hitch taken. First hitch taken. And then you will take three winds. This is the first wind. This is the second wind. And this is the third wind. All the three winds will be taken on the both the loop, over the loop, both the thread. And then this is the last locking hitch, should be on the one side of the thread. So this way Rotter's knot can be tightened. So you can remember the Rotter's knot by 1-3-1. That is one hitch, three wind and one locking hitch. And you can push it with the help of the knot cushion. So this was regarding the Rotter's knot. And we can see here, again I will show you that how to tie it. So this is the hitch taken. This is the first hitch, and this hitch should be from below up, and then it will be followed by the three winds, and all the winds will be taken on both the side of the thread. In this way you can take the wind on the both the side of the thread. Three winds will be taken, and then one locking hitch should be taken around this one side of the thread. This is a single hitch, and you can remember this is also known as half knot or locking knot. So you can remember by 131, and then it will be pushed by the help of the knot pusher, and it is going and it is tightened. So I will just demonstrate you how to do. Just this is the finger of the assistant will be like that, and this way this is the long one. You should hold it this way. This is the short arm, this is the long arm, and then you should cross it. After crossing it, shorter is above the longer. And the role of index finger and thumb of the left hand is very important. So the pinch it by the left hand and the thumb. And then always remember a principle form going from below up. So you will go like this, index finger up, thumb up. This is one hitch. Again you go index finger up, thumb up. This is first wind. Pinch it by the left hand. Again this is the second wind. And this is the third wind. And after that you go on one side of the thread and put your middle finger in this groove. Touch by the thumb and bring it down and catch by these two fingers and pull it. And this way Rodder's knot is ready. And then you can push the Rodder's knot towards the target. Remember that we do three mistakes during the tying the knot. What are those mistakes? The first mistake is that when you have taken the knot, like this is the knot, and you have taken, then what happens that inadvertently it will be pulled and it will be locked there. So there are two threads. This is the long and this is the shorter one. The purpose of your left hand index finger and thumb is keep longer one straight. Don't allow it to get turned. Otherwise it will not slip. So you keep this hitch in such a way that it should be straight. You got it? This is the first mistake which we do. And in the beginning only it is locked. Second mistake what we do, that when you are taking the wind, this is first wind, this is second wind, this is third wind, it is stacked properly one after another. Just like the his pagri, you can see it is stacked properly one after another. And then it is known as it will hold, it will make a cup, and it will not leave the tissue, because the purpose of the winds are, it is making a hollow suction cup in which tissue will get trapped like that. So it should never be overridden, like when you have taken the first wind. And if you are taking second one, and if it is over the first like that, it is wrong. It should be stacked just like a coin, one after another. So how to do? When you have taken the first hitch, then hold it by the index finger and thumb. Then again take the second hitch, again you catch it. Again take the third hitch, again you catch it. So it is stacked properly. And then you are taking the last locking hitch or locking knot. So this is the second mistake we do, that is the knots are overridden. Third mistake what happens generally is that your knots are elongated. How it is elongated? That this is your first hitch, that is very good. But your these short ends are elongated over the long one, like this. You have taken your knot this way. This is wrong, because they are not stacked properly and it will fall out. Just like if Sikh people, they are putting the pagri, and if it is not stacked properly, it will drop. If you just anyhow, if you will put it, same way.